We're now in our holiday season and it's gonna start, or it started already. Maraming Christmas parties. Right now, I'm here at the Cuisine Experience and Design Studio in Makati, the distributors of Kogan Paul. The most beautiful design in kitchens. Anyway, our first recipe for the day is something that's Italian, something different, something that's easy to make. This recipe is baked meatballs. It's going to be very simple. It's so different and delicious. These are the ingredients for preparing my baked meatballs. Ground beef, ground pork, finely chopped onions and garlic, oregano, grated Parmesan cheese, breadcrumbs, a cup of milk, and 2 beaten eggs. For the sauce, these are the ingredients. Olive oil, garlic, red pepper flakes, canned tomatoes, water, oregano, seasoning liquid, salt, pepper, Gruyere cheese, and Parmesan cheese. We have some ground beef, yan. We have ground pork. Look at this. Just make sure that your hands are clean, okay? And then we have some onions, chopped onions, finely chopped onions. We have some garlic. Okay, here you need a lot of patience. Then we have dried oregano. Yan. We have some breadcrumbs. We have some milk. Parmesan cheese. Okay. This is all baking, huh? And then egg. This is going to bind everything together. Okay, now, this is where the patience comes in. Yan. Yan. Okay, what I like to do when I mix is I start from the side and bring the meat inside and slowly lang. You know, right now you can see one side is color yellow, the other side is color green, but later on, we're trying to get a uniform color in all this mixture, okay? Okay, so I'm going to make the meatballs. I'm going to make them big. Yan. Look at that, oh. Those are big meatballs. Okay, maybe I'll need 2 containers for this. I like them huge. I like them round. Yan. So they're mixed very well already, no? And what I'm going to do with this is I'm going to bake this for about 20 minutes at 350 degrees. Why 20 minutes lang? It might not be fully cooked, but what'll happen here is I'm going to bake it again because I'm going to make a sauce. It's like a lasagna without the pasta. Yan na. Okay, that's it. And I'm going to bake this already, okay? Come. Let me open this. Yan! And then, we have the right temperature. We just press OK. That's ready to go. Now we make the sauce for our meatballs. So extra virgin olive oil. I always like to work with extra virgin olive oil. Our extra virgin olive oil is nice and hot. Okay, so let's just wait for our garlic to shrink a little bit. Then we have some chili flakes that'll add a little kick to our tomato sauce. Yan. Then I'm going to add my canned tomatoes. You know, I used to frown at these canned tomatoes kasi parang, canned. You know, apparently in Italy, what they do is they can it. So it's like having fresh chopped tomatoes also. Okay. Then we're going to add in some water. Yan. We're going to add in some oregano. Okay. And then some basil. Yan. These are the herbs that will, ooze out a certain aroma that'll make it so delicious. Okay? Seasoning liquid is my secret ingredient. I love putting seasoning liquid on everything. And then salt and pepper. Yan. Put my salt. Little bit lang. Konti. Salt, pwede. Okay. Just mix everything together. And what we will do, just simmer this a little bit. This is done. Let's just wait for our bola bola. Okay, this one's done. We will now get the meatballs. Now we're going to pour our sauce and add the Gruyere cheese all over it, followed by the Parmesan cheese. All right, I'm going to bring this back to the oven and bake it for another 20 minutes at 200 degrees, and that's it. Yeah, trust me, this is something that your family will love because it's delicious, it's unique, and it'll surprise everyone. My baked meatballs. Up next, our next recipe for our Christmas parties is going to be a crispy eggplant with anchovy sauce. You have to wait for this, it's so good. Our next recipe for our Christmas parties is going to be a crispy eggplant with anchovy sauce. To prepare this simple but delicious dish for your Christmas party, we will need 2 large eggplants, eggs, cornstarch, breadcrumbs, and oil. We're going to serve the eggplants with anchovy dip, which is made up of drained artichoke, anchovy fillets, spring onions, lemon juice, extra virgin olive oil, cream cheese, and a cup of cream. I've gotten some sliced eggplants. These are your regular eggplants. Okay, I soaked it in water just so that it doesn't oxidize right away. So put it in some paper towel, pat dry it. Okay, and I'll do the same with all of them. So drain a little bit. You know what I've done? I put a little lemon juice on the eggplant so that it doesn't discolor. There's a little acid in the lemon juice. Okay, now we have some 4 eggs. Okay, best combination for crispiness are eggs or egg white and cornstarch eggs. We'll coat each eggplant with this and cornstarch. And then, okay, I have some cooking oil that I'm heating already. That's ready to go. If you look at it, it's very, very simple. But you know what? With the anchovy sauce, it will bring this to life. Food is like that also. Wait, let me use a wire whip. Okay, just to smoothen out the cornstarch and the egg mixture. I have some breadcrumbs. You know, I suggest you can use the Japanese breadcrumbs if you like. That's really up to you. Now we're going to put our eggplant here. Yan. Now what'll happen here is the batter make the eggplant sticky so that when you drop it into the breadcrumbs, it's going to mix well. Okay, mix. You know, maybe you can season the cornstarch and egg so that if you bite into the eggplant and there is no sauce, you know, it'll stand on its own without the sauce, okay? Okay, eggs and breadcrumbs. Yan. Okay, so let's get the ones that have been soaked in cornstarch and egg. So all the sides, including the skin. Yan, look at that. It's beautiful. Yan. Okay. So what I'll do is I'll just fry all of these until they're nice and crunchy and then make our anchovy sauce, okay? Ayun. Yan, we're done. Okay, we're done with our crispy eggplants. Now we're going to make the sauce. So here they are. I have a blender here. We're going to put our all-purpose cream. If you can get, you know, good cream, better. Okay, but if not, all-purpose cream will do. For those of your experience, you may use your imagination and put ingredients that you think will work. Okay, extra virgin olive oil, chopped spring onions, okay, cream cheese, and then lemon juice. We have some anchovies. You cannot put too much anchovies, otherwise it'll overpower, no? Artichokes. Ooh, I love artichokes. Yan. Yan yan. That's as simple as that. Now, what we will do is blend all of these together like this. You'll know that it's mixing well when you see the rotation all the way to the top. Let's see. Let's see. Yow. Look at that. Whoa. Crispy eggplant with anchovy sauce. This is so good. Up next. Now, this dish is something that's so simple to make. Anybody can make this, even an amateur cook. Steamed chicken with the ginger spring onion sauce. From Europe or Italy, we travel to Asia. You know, a lot of families, they have a lot of very good food. But the problem is, when you serve that food too often, your family gets tired. So the idea that we have here on Casa Dasa is throw you dishes that are unusual, something that will surprise your family, and of course, they have to be delicious. Now, this dish is something that's so simple to make. Anybody can make this, even an amateur cook. I'm going to show you how to make a simple steamed ginger chicken. To prepare steamed ginger chicken, we have boneless chicken thighs, ginger, soy sauce, oyster sauce, sugar, salt, pepper, cornstarch, spring onion sauce, which is basically made up of ginger, spring onions, salt, oyster sauce, sesame oil, and cooking oil. Okay, this is what we will do. In a bowl, we'll just get our ginger, okay? Strips of ginger. We have some soy sauce, okay? Look at this. Look how simple this is, okay? So if you've never cooked in your life, this is what I call a confidence-building recipe. So I'm putting oyster sauce. No, I have, by the way, this is a steamed chicken dish. I have a steam going on already. We have some brown sugar. Okay. Just follow the proportions. We have a little salt. Not that much because we have soy sauce already, so that's salty. We have pepper for that little kick. And then we have cornstarch. Okay. Now, my favorite part of the chicken is the chicken thigh. So, I have boneless chicken thigh. Yeah, so this is our marinade mixture. Cornstarch, oyster sauce, soy sauce. Let's taste it nga. Pwede. And then we add in our chicken thigh. This is the size of the chicken thigh, so that's the size. You can use whatever cut of chicken you like. No, that's really totally up to you. Okay, mix it together very, very well. So we've mixed the chicken very well in our marinade. We will remove our cover, okay, and pour our chicken inside. It's that simple. Yawn. Yan. Okay. We are just going to steam this for about 30 minutes, 40 minutes. You know, if you can find a bamboo steamer, okay yan. Good. Okay? Now, while we're waiting for this to cook, what I'll do is I'll make the sauce. I'm going to start making our ginger and spring onion sauce. This is delicious. Okay, so what we will do is we will heat our cooking oil first. Okay. We are going to mix grated ginger. Okay. Grated ginger. We have some chopped spring onions. Then we have a little salt just to season this mixture. We have some oyster sauce. I just added this oyster sauce. Normally, you don't, eh? Pero it's why not, diba? Be creative. And then we have some sesame oil. Okay? And then all we have to do is just mix all of these ingredients together. We'll come back to this one, okay? Let's check if our oil is hot enough. I have this wooden, it's a tong, okay? I'm looking for bubbles on the side of the tong, the wooden tong. Okay, this is hot enough. What I'll do is just pour this here, okay? Yan. Wow. What's happening here is the hot oil is cooking the ginger and the spring onion with all the flavorings. And that's it. It's that simple lang. Yan na. And that's your sauce. Sauce is done. We're just waiting for the chicken to cook. Okay, so this one is done. You know what? Something like this, yung steamed chicken, there's a tendency, very, very minimal tendency to overcook it. Why? Because you're steaming it. And overcooking is removing of evaporation. So it's steaming, it's fine. This one's ready, this one's cooked. I'm just going to combine this with our ginger spring onion sauce. And my favorite portion, tasting time. We have a steamed ginger chicken. Check out my Christmas party dishes. Look at these. I don't even have to tell you how delicious this is. Look at that. Oh. Mm. Check out my Christmas party dishes. Look at these, huh? First of all, what we did was baked meatballs with tomato sauce. It's a little bit spicy. There's a nice kick to it. Then we have a crispy eggplant with anchovy sauce with cream cheese. Unique and delicious. Lastly, from Europe, we flew to Asia and we have a steamed ginger chicken. Diba? Let's start tasting. Let us get some of this crispy eggplant. Dip it in this anchovy cream sauce. You know, when you come out with a dish like this, there's only one way to find out. You have to try it yourself. And you saw how I made it. It's very, very simple. You can just make it at home. Yummy. Harap. Now, let's try our chicken naman. Europe, we flew to Asia. Look at this. Steamed boneless ginger chicken. I'll try it without the sauce first. I have a ginger sauce here on the side. Actually, it's very flavored already. Naman. This is a dish that's very close to home because the ingredients are something that we're familiar with, di ba? Mmm. It's sweetish. There's a little kick from the spice of the ginger. Yung parang sarap. Now, let me try the ginger sauce. Okay, then. Sarap. Mmm. Very good, with or without the sauce. And you know, the steamed ginger is unique. It's so good. Ulam. Mm. Mm. Let's have our baked meatballs. What's that, oh? Oh my, you know, I can't help but notice every time I put a dish on the plate. Look at how beautiful my plates are. These are from my happy home of Happy Umpawa. Happy, thank you, ah. Ganda. Ayan, ganda. Anyway. Whoa. Ayan, oh. I don't even have to tell you how delicious this is. Look at that, oh. Mmm. I can taste the oregano. I can taste the Parmesan cheese. There's a little kick from the spice of the yung chili flakes from the sauce. Sarap nito. And you can even eat this with ano eh, garlic rice. Sarap. Hmm? There you have it, our festive Christmas party dishes. We have crispy eggplant with anchovy sauce, steamed chicken with ginger sauce, and a most delicious meatballs in mildly spicy tomato sauce. So delicious. I'll see you again next week for another Casa Dasa with all my brand new recipes. Ta-ta!